This is just, I assume, Mike and Steve, just before the match got underway and Masala Torre has dressed out for this, which means if he gets pinned, it's all over.
That's exactly right. This was their mistake. As long as he stays out on the floor and just tries to get involved or interfere when somebody's back is turned, he's safe. This was their downfall, bringing him into the ring as a partner.
Of course, he is an extremely capable wrestler, twice bantamweight champion, but again, we get back to about 100 pounds weight difference.
That's exactly right. He's a great amateur wrestler. I think once or twice world Greco champion, freestyle champion. But that's amateur. That's with the little boys. That's not for the money. That's not when you can break somebody's arms and legs.
Well, obviously here he continues to work out, so he realizes the full importance of the situation and extremely powerful for his son.
Yes, he is. He's a strong little guy, but he never really got a chance to use his strength. The only times he came in the ring was when we were already down.
Well, the introduction's being made at this time now, and of course the United States Tag Team Championship on the line. And this was another condition that if you had to be in a down position.
That's right. I had to be in a down position, Steve, or I either one, if we were going to start any match with him. And here I'm down, just tell him to come on, get on, hop on. I'll take him for a ride.
Andy doesn't appear to be too anxious for this at all, and now you're really taking a chance.
Well, I didn't think I was taking a chance with a man as small as him.
And Hattori still trying to make up his mind.
As quick as he is, you see me leg diving right here. Leg diving from my hands and knees.
And a very quick escape from Saito. Now with Steve Kern, you're back outside the ring. And Steve, what were you thinking at this point in time?
Well, Gordon, right here, I was in there with Sato, and I knew that they knew that they had a risk with if they ever had Torre get in the ring. It's a fight. We knew it was going to be a fight to the finish. And like with Torre on the outside, that's just an extra man. He may not be big, but he might be able to get in there and do some damage.
Mike, they've caught you in the throat.
Yeah, he hit me with a karate. I just felt a man on my back and just started doing some sitting out and switching. I didn't really realize who was back there. He was moving back and forth. I didn't realize that it was Hattori that was in the ring until right about now.
Yeah, I can see that your look of recognition crossing you and very quickly back to your feet now. And I think Masao Hattori beginning to realize the mistake he's made.
That's exactly right. He realized that he was a good wrestler with a man his size, not with one 100 pounds heavier.
Bit of a free-for-all breaking up here, and Steve, you certainly took matters into control.
Well, Gordon, if you notice, all three of them were in the ring at one time, so at that point, that was where I had to come in there and help Mike out.
Mike, you've got it back under control yourself now.
Well, you know, you never really have a match totally under control when you're wrestling against athletes such as these, just like right here. I thought I had the man under control, and he stood me on my head.
Belly-to-belly souffle, and now the tag is made. Steve Kern charges the ring again, using that very, very lethal forearm smash. Backdrops him coming off the rings, and Steve, I know you had some hamstring muscle problems recently, but you appear to be at full tilt here.
Well, Gordon, I felt good. Both Mike and myself felt good, and I think you were up for it that night. And by the reaction of the people, they had a feeling that we were going to have a good match. So we step in. All you have to do is make one little mistake, though. Here, Torrey's on my back like a little fly. I'm pulling him, trying to pull him off, and he's hanging on for dear life. And now he's got to have his outside man help him interfere.
Well, that's one thing the Japanese duo have been famous for, is the interference of Masala Torre. But at least in this particular match, Mike, you and Steve know where he is and what he's about to do.
That's exactly right. We know if he gets in the ring and gets pinned, that they'll lose the titles. That they won't be disqualified for him interfering. That they will lose the titles.
And the rule book just went out the window.
Well, you know, sometimes you can be an athlete, you can be a sportsman, but when it comes time to get down to the nut cutting, you got to get it done.
And that's exactly what's being done right here. Mike Graham coming off the ropes, a good shoulder smash. He's off the ropes, tripped up by Hattori from outside. And, Steve, you're moving around the outside of the ring, trying to make sure that doesn't happen again. And we have Sato outside in a, three-way battle going here. And, Mike, you stopped him short.
Well, sometimes, you know, you got to do what's necessary. I saw the men coming in the ring and just trying to protect myself.
Both men crashing together now, both men down on the canvas, and Steve trying to get some advantage here, both men over the top rope. Hattori staggered, and we have a dangerous situation moving.
That's exactly right. A very dangerous situation. Both of us were knocked out. I didn't know what was going on at this point.
count of three, a count of three, Hattori, in an effort to try and help things, has actually destroyed his own team.
Well, I guess that's one time in his eagerness to get in and try to help his team that he just made the wrong move.